but I think you've got my chair. No, that one's not taken, I don't mind if you sit here.
Okay, folks, it's time for one of my favorite George Strait songs, The Chair. Now, this one is in the key of A. You've got a lot of stuff to do in this one. Not so much a lot of stuff to do, but a lot of different things to do that you may not be used to doing. And here's how we get them accomplished. Okay, it's in the key of A. Your rhythm pattern will actually be very straightforward. Root note, just a bunch of up and down strokes, so it's just like that. Okay, now the thing is, it's got a lot of chords, a lot of chords in this song. They are going to be A, but you will never play a regular A chord. That is not the way it's done in here. If you want to, go ahead. But if you want to do it right, it's actually played like this. That's the way it's actually played on the album. Okay? So that being just a regular A chord, barred across the second fret, covering your D, G, and B strings, then barring your pinky, heck of a stretch. But this is the way it's really done. I teach it the way it's supposed to be. Okay? You do what you want after that. I'll hide these fingers so you can see that they're not played. But pinky, covering the fifth fret on the E string and the B string. If you want to fight about it, here it is, listen. So you can hear the high notes. It's not going. Okay, it's that way. So that's the way she actually goes. The other chords in the song are B minor. Okay, so hopefully you know your minor chords because there are a few in here. And there are some other things that I don't care to figure out what the heck they're called. They're B flat to the ninth power times pi. That I'll show you how to play. So you got B minor in here also. If you don't know your minors, real quick, it's the same as any other bar chord at the top, but actually move down a string. So real quick, I'm going to show you one minor, and all the rest of them are going to be the same. So second fret, A string, fourth fret, D string, fourth fret, G string, third fret, B string, and your bar across with your first finger is on your E string. Going to be a C sharp minor, and we're also going to have a regular E chord, and our one other chord, and we're also going to have a D chord, and the other chord in here is going to be that one that I said was all over the place. It's actually the second chord that's in Friends in Low Places, if you've ever played it before. It's the mystery chord. Is to play that chord, it's actually a variation of a B-flat, augmented type of thing. You have first finger, first fret, A string, middle finger, second fret, D string, pinky, third fret, so you're just building a ladder. First, second, third, as ugly as it sounds, so third fret on your G string, then your ring finger, second fret on the B string, then your high E string is open. Yep, you use that three times in the song. And at one point, you're the only one playing, so you better learn that chord because everybody else stops and you have to be playing it. Okay? So where all this comes in, the D. I'll look you to and to tell you the truth. Then you got that chord in there. Then B minor. It wasn't my chair after all. They all come in that quick. So that little progression again is I like you. So there's your D. To, that's your C sharp minor, and to tell you, B minor, then funky chord, I'll just call it from here on out, the truth, then B minor, that wasn't my E after A, Okay, mm-hmm. So they're going to go by that quick. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and start the song, and I will yell the chords out to you while the song is playing. When I say funky chord, we're just going to call it that, okay? That's that. Get used to playing that on your own time. I won't waste the time on the video. But now, just remember, I like it too, to tell you the truth. I was in my chair after all. So get used to playing those chords in that order before we even progress, okay? And then come back to this, okay? So hopefully you've done that by now. That's the magic of pause or stop. Okay, so here we go from the beginning. The chair, I'll yell out the chords to you. And remember, our A's are always going to be with the pinky there. If you don't do it, that's up to you, but here's the right way. Don't say I didn't teach you right. Here we go. A. To E, Edward. A. B minor. E. Back to A. Quick switch. It changes all the time. B minor. Now it won't do it again for a long time. Back to E. Back to A. Back to B minor. Back to E. Now it never does that again. Back to A. Now B minor, E. B minor, E, A. Now it'll never do that again. B minor. Here comes that whole thing. D, C sharp minor, B minor, funky chord, B minor, E, A. That's why you gotta go back and practice that. That's really quick. B minor. E. A. B minor. E. And A. B minor. Now we got A, F sharp minor. I'll say that again. There's D, C sharp minor, B minor, funky chord, B minor, E, A. Here comes where you play it by yourself. Go into dog, D, D, C sharp minor, B minor, funky chord, U. B minor, E, A. Okay, now to straighten out one little thing in there is you noticed I went, I don't mind at all. Okay, what that is A with your pinky here. Then you bring your pinky back only on the high E string to the 4th fret, then we go to F sharp minor, okay, 2nd fret all the way across, and then you just put your ring finger, 4th fret, A string, and your pinky right under it, 4th fret on the D string. So back to the A, I don't mind at all. Then back to the I love you too, but to tell you the truth, that wasn't my chair after all. Then it goes, I like you too, let me tell you the truth. And there you hit everything but the high E string. You don't hit the last one, so just. That wasn't my chair. Some noodling around at the end. Okay? So that is it as far as the rhythm goes. That's a lot in there. Once again, that
I don't mind at all.
Sorry for my singing, but it just bring the pinky back one. So you originally covered both strings, the E and the B string, with that pinky. Now the pinky back only on the high E string to the fourth fret. Then the F sharp minor, which I remembered right when it came to it. So there's how she goes. I'm going to shut up. We're going to play the backing track right now. And this is what you'll also play the lead guitar too. You'll come back to this one. So I will shut up and actually just let you play along. And you'll play the lead guitar part with this track also. So I'm just going to crank up the music. And here we go. You can watch my fingers if you need any reference from here out. Track. Remember, at the very end, if you do, you tell you the truth. You can add the last one in if you want, because it's there. Okay, so it's just noodling at the end. So now we're actually going to go to the lead part. A lot of the steel stuff I'll actually show you on guitar. All the and all that kind of stuff will all be there. So anything that's done on steel and or guitar will be shown to you. Okay, and then you'll come back and play with this track that we just did. So that's a lot of work for the rhythm players out there. More work than that's actually going to come up in the lead. So there's the chair solos and lead stuff coming up right after this. All right, it is time to do the lead guitar work on the chair. All right. A lot of this is actually done on guitar. It sounds like steel, but it's actually just a guitar with a compressor on it. So, anyway, here's our licks. We'll go right into this thing. We'll pick them apart, and you can put them together. Here we go. Okay, gotta get that one right off the bat. Very easy. Even though the song is in A, we are working out of a E type of a situation, bar chord type of thing. So I want your first finger across the ninth fret, across the G and the D and the B string, so D, G, B string, making an E chord. And now what we have to do is take our middle finger and put it on the 10th fret of the B string. Okay? So what we're looking at is playing that B string with your finger at the 10th fret and pull it off. And then we just play the other two strings. And just hammer on the D string onto the 11th fret. So we start at the 10th fret on the B string. Pull off, play the G string, play the D string, then hammer on to the 11th fret. Then piano, us again. Okay, and that's it for us. Okay, so let's just go check her out. We can play right along with it. Here we go. Us again. Us.
Well, excuse me.
Okay, I'll show you when we have something else.
Got my chance.
Piano.
No, that one's not taken. I don't
nothing for us.
If you sit here, I'll be glad to share your Tuesday. Back here on Friday night.
Volume pedals.
You don't mind, girl,
okay, so you can actually do swells then. Then. If you want to, which was just on B string, 5, 7, 9, and then 12. Okay, you heard those back here. They're actually guitar, just doing volume pedal swells. It's not steel guitar.
Oh, if you don't mind,
okay.
If
I'll go back a little bit.
Mind, back to your own Friday night.
Seventh fret. Ninth fret. So that one part is this. 12th fret, high E string. Start with it bent up towards the ceiling. Or, okay, so bend it up to the F sharp. Instead of... So we start it bent up. Back down to the 12th fret. Then your B string, 14th fret, and then 12th fret again on your high E string. And then we actually finish out an E chord type of thing. Then back to the 12th fret, B string, pull off to the 14th fret, pull off to the 12th. So 14, 12. Then we go 13, 11, 10 on the G string. Okay. Pretty much like that. Okay, so we'll come right back to that. Here we go. That's got us for a while. B minor. Fiddle guy. Nothing for you. Okay, here's us. The next lick coming down. Will be our next lick. Okay, so this coming down out of the D is simple stuff, coming off of the 7th fret across the D, G, and B string. So D string, B string, G string, then back to the D string. So you're making a minor out of it. 5th fret B string, 6th fret G, 6th fret D. Playing that way, B, G, D string. So you got... Move the whole thing down a whole step. So you're at 3-4-4. Then you're at 2-3-2 going down on the D string. 2-3-2, because you play it down. That makes two of us right back where we were at 3-2-2. Then E. Which is twice on D note, 3rd fret, B string. And you pull off to the 2nd fret. Then hit it again. Now we do. So 2nd fret twice on the E string. Pull off open. Then hit it again. So we have... Then we go on the E string, 5-4-2. Don't know the name of the band, they're good. Then we go right to the E chord. So, from the beginning. We choose you, well, that makes two of us. That lick will be simply at the 12th fret, E string, and B string. Then E string on the 9th fret, and B string on the 10th fret. And then we'll repeat it again, and that's it. Okay? So here we go from that walk down.
I don't think I hold your name.
Okay, walk down from this D.
Are you waiting for someone to meet you here? Well, that one makes two of us glad you came.
Now our little leg. That little thing there was actually a fiddle lick, but it's good for a guitar player. If you don't have a fiddle, it's just A, 10th fret on the B string. Swell it in if you can. Volume pedal, better than anything with a compressor. So 10, 9, 7. To hear that, here we are. Nothing new. Now this again. Again, same thing. Now we stop. Let the acoustic guy play. Now we do that same lick again. Beginning. Okay. So what we do differently at the end is instead of, we actually go the first time, starting on the 12th fret on the B string. So we just leave out the first note, so it's, then our intro lick. I like to grab my middle finger there. Grab the middle finger on the D string on the 9th fret. If you have more strength to pull it down with, use that thumb hard to press against. For the ending. And that is it. So that's the outro, if you will. Here we go. Here's the outro. Let the acoustic player. Nothing here. Just start on the B string. Now the high E string. And that's it. Okay. So go back and play with the track. You have all that fun stuff. And your swells in from the... Yes, from the 5 to the 7 to the 9 to the 12. And then the walk down for the fiddle part with the A flat and then your F sharp. Then the very ending of... the fiddle or the acoustic finish out. It was in my chair after B string. Then high E. Cross over with your middle finger. Drag it down towards the floor, whole step. And you're out of there. So go back, work with the track. Every note there is picture perfect. Okay? So you can't lose. So there's the end of the chair, kiddies. Time to get out of the chair and go to something else.